If you've watched any of my other videos, you may have noticed that I'm a little bit obsessed with ITED and their Sonoff switches. Among all their other cool products, ITED also has a low voltage version of the Sonoff called the SV. SV stands for safe voltage. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the SV to make a battery powered Wi-Fi button. I found the SV when I was looking for a cool home assistant controlled switch for my crown molding LED lights, and the SV fit the task perfectly. The SV works just like the Sonoff Basic. It has an ESP8266 Wi-Fi chip, a relay, and a power converter. You can put anything between 5 and 24 volts on the input side. The power converter gives the ESP chip the little bit of power that it needs, and the rest is switched by the relay and then goes out the output side to power your low voltage device. But then somebody asked me what they could do in a three-way switch situation if they wanted to add a switch in a location where they didn't already have wiring and a switch box. That gave me an idea for a really cool use for the Sonoff SV. Let's turn it into a battery-powered Wi-Fi button. There are a lot of different ways to build a battery-powered Wi-Fi button. The method I'm going to show you is not going to be the fanciest, it's not going to be the smallest, but it'll work. And it may very well be the easiest method you'll find. Initially, I tried powering it with two AAA batteries, which should give about 3.2, 3.3 volts, but that just wasn't quite enough to get the board to power up. So I connected it to a 9-volt battery, and it worked great. Another good thing about using a 9-volt battery is it's almost the same size and shape as the Sonoff SV itself. It's also possible to isolate the relay from the power that's going to the Wi-Fi chip. Probably the most common use for something like that is a situation maybe like your garage doors where you want to power the Sonoff, but you don't necessarily need power running through the Sonoff to your device. You just want the relay to connect and disconnect a couple of wires. This really is a useful little board. I like it. And because so much of the lighting in our house these days is low voltage LEDs, a little board like the Sonoff SV is just going to find more and more uses. I like to change the firmware on my Sonoffs to Tasmota for a few reasons. Number one is I want to be able to control my Sonoffs through my home automation hub, which for me is Home Assistant. With Tasmota, I can use MQTT, which is a great way for your devices and your hub to communicate. The native Sonoff software can't do that. Tasmota also lets you communicate with other home automation hubs. So pretty much no matter which home automation hub you're using, Tasmota is your friend. Number two, with Tasmota, you can use the other GPIO pins. I like to use GPIO 14 as a switch, but there are also other ways to make use of the other GPIO pins. The native Sonoff firmware doesn't let you do that. Those extra pins are just kind of left hanging there with nothing to do. Third, Tasmota works on a bunch of different devices, including just about all of these Sonoff devices, but also the D1 Mini and the Node MCU. I really like getting familiar with one software that I can use on a whole variety of devices, and Tasmota is that kind of software. I can report that the Sonoff SV can be flashed with the over-the-air method. Fortunately, I bought mine before version 1.6 came out. But the manual hardwired method also works perfectly well. These are the serial pins that you need if you're doing the manual wired method for flashing. And to get the board in programming mode, it's just like a basic. You hold down the onboard button when you power on the board. With the hardwired flashing method, your Wi-Fi information and your MQTT information all goes in to the userconfig.h file, so when you flash the board the first time, it's ready to go. If you want to use GPIO 14 for a switch, this is where you find it on the board, and the setup in the configuration is the same as with a basic. It seems like the intent of this board is more for development than for general consumer use, because it doesn't come with any kind of a plastic cover, and the only way to connect on the input and output terminals is by soldering. But there are headers for the GPIO pins. Go figure. As is my usual solution when I need a case for something, I designed and 3D printed one that would fit the battery, the Sonoff, and a button. But since not everybody has the ability to 3D print yet, you can also run down to a dollar store or someplace like Walmart and pick up a soap dish, kind of like this, for about a dollar. That works great as a case. Just drill a hole in the top that's the right size to fit your switch, and then put the Sonoff and the battery inside, snap it shut. A little bit of double-sided tape, and you can stick this button anywhere you want. I was really excited about this button. I tested it, and I got it working great. Then I set it on my desk, and I went to bed. I spent the next few days working on making the video. Some of you might be able to guess where this is going. When I went back to my desk and tried to use my beautiful new button, it didn't work. The battery was dead. What I had failed to do was calculate how long the battery would last. A typical 9-volt battery has a capacity of about 500 milliamps. According to Sonoff's datasheet, the SV will draw an average of 80 milliamps. So my abacus tells me that battery will last 6.25 hours. That sucks. I took a few minutes to feel sorry for myself. And then I panicked about what I was gonna do for a video this week. Since now, I couldn't really use this not so awesome anymore battery button. But then I said to myself, self, it's okay to fail. In fact, some wise fictional mentor, or maybe it was a superhero's uncle, once said, failure is the best teacher. So rather than scrap the whole idea, I decided to go ahead with the video. And in the process, I found out that Tasmota actually has a command that will put the board to sleep for 250 milliseconds at a time. And that will drop the power usage down to a third of normal, or maybe even less. Cool. That turns our 6-hour battery into an 18-hour battery. Not bad. Still not good enough. But that sleep command might be useful in other situations. And if I hadn't failed with the battery thing, I would have never found it. How about that? As a last resort, if you really want to have a battery-powered Wi-Fi button, you can always just put a switch on the battery. Then, of course, every time you want to press the button, you've got to flip the switch first to turn the battery on. Never mind. Don't do that. I now call this the button of shame. But I'm going to keep it, just to remind me that failing is okay. Besides finding the sleep command, there's another silver lining to this story. When I was scrambling to try and come up with an idea for a video for this week using the Sonoff SV, I decided to get deeper into the idea of using the Sonoff SV to control my garage doors, and I solved it. I thought about rushing to get the video done on the garage doors, but I decided it's more important to take my time and do a good job and put out something that's really worth watching. So stay tuned. Next week, I'll have a well put together video about the Sonoff SV to control your garage doors, because that's what you deserve. Thanks for watching. Until next time, adios.